any man of mine.
Another Canadian would become a record breaker, this time in the world of country music.
Gotta shimmy and shake, I make the earthquake.
But Shania Twain, the polished performer, was a world away from Eileen Twain, the shy girl from Northern Ontario with a dream but many hurdles to cross.
It's a rags to riches story. It's a one in a million story.
Eileen is a 21-year-old Ojibwe singer from Timmins, once financed her singing lessons by waitressing. She writes her own lyrics, and as well as preparing for her debut at Thompson Hall, she's working on an album John Kim will produce.
There's something funny. There's an awkward beat that kind of floats in there. Know what I'm saying?
Who is that guy?
To make you wait.
I had been a well-known Broadway conductor in New York City, and I had been the apprentice conductor of the Toronto Symphony, and I'd worked with lots and lots of singers in New York who came from wealthy families. They had millions of dollars of lessons and training and dance lessons and movement lessons on top of it. Eileen was a poor kid growing up. She was self-taught. I had started a charitable foundation to help young Indigenous people. My whole passion is that if given the opportunity, I was certain many of us could succeed. It's just that we don't have the opportunity. We're poor. She was mad at me because she thought I was being too hard on her, because we talked about it afterwards. Her name is Eileen, two L's, two E's. Her mother had divorced her biological father. She married Jerry Twain, who was a member of the Bear Island First Nation. I mean, in our cultures, Indigenous people adopted people all the time who weren't Indigenous, and they became members of the family. And that's what happened to her. And you know, it's not a right or a wrong to it. That's how she grew up. The parents had a contract planting trees north of the tree line in Timmins, Ontario. That's how she ended up in Timmins.
She was raised in a family that really struggled financially. As a singer, she started really young, like at 8 years old. And you can only imagine a pint-sized kid with a big guitar singing Dolly Parton songs.
When I first met her, she was 11 years old. I was doing a concert, and she was the opening act, and this little girl walked on the stage with a guitar in her hand, and out came this sound, this magnificent, breathtaking sound.
It was Shania's mom, Sharon, that was more motivated to have her be successful. That really was the stage mom that, you know, made sure that she had the costumes and the clothes and the hair and the opportunities and things. But you could see she was very confident. Didn't look like she was afraid about being up on stage.
The beer they say is cold in old Milwaukee.
No question, she just opens up her mouth, and for me, I hear it. It's a gift beyond us. And so I said to Sharon, you know, this girl is going to be something very special. It was 7, 8 years later when the accident happened.
When Shania was 21, her life was shattered. Her parents were killed in a car crash. She had to raise the family.
When Shania's parents died, Mary was the person that Shania went to tell her, I can't be in music anymore. Like, I'm giving up my music career. I got to raise my brothers.
I remember the phone call. Yeah, we hadn't spoken in a while. And she called and said, you know, I don't know what I'm going to do. And that's when I said to her, you know exactly what you're going to do. You're going to do what God gave you, and that's to sing. I got her the gig at Deerhurst.
I think it was 3 or 4 years she worked at Deerhurst, a resort in Ontario, and she did Broadway hits and jazz, and she sang in a lounge there. She wanted to stay in music, but she had to do it in a way that she could help raise her brothers and her younger sister.
And that was a big turning moment for her. I think that's where she really came out and became a seasoned professional. She'd sing a few songs that really required her to belt out the music, and she was magnificent.
From the age of 8 years old, I've been singing in clubs. I've been filling my lungs with secondhand smoke, and these were all classes in life and in my career that I took to become the artist that I am right now.
And now, one of the hottest rising stars in country music, here singing sensation Shania Twain and her new single, Any Man of Mine.
Yeah. Now this is what a woman wants.
Well, any man of mine better be proud of me. Even when I'm ugly, he still better love me. I can be late for a date, that's fine, but he better be on time.
It's country music that rocks and rolls, thanks to hotshot rock and roll producer Mutt Lange, Shania's husband.
She met Mutt. He was a brilliant pop composer. You know, she didn't think she could break into the pop world, so she thought there was this new category called new country. I had invited Eileen to perform on the annual National Aboriginal Achievement Awards. She was becoming the hot rising star. I had watched this long arc of a life. This was another person. This was Shania, the performer. And hiding in there was Eileen, the person, the one I always knew.
Well, I was actually at that performance. She is packaged then. She's sassy, she's confident, she owns the stage. And that took 10 years of evolution as a musician to get to that point.
Shania has been waiting in the wings and suffering for her craft ever since she was a little girl. Through poverty, through the loss of her parents, through every hardship, she never lost focus that I am going to be a famous singer. God damn it, she did it.
Oh, come on, everybody. Oh,